Hello students, this is Abhijit Mukherjee. Today we are going to study Class 7 Science, Chapter 15, Light. We shall learn in this chapter about rectilinear propagation of light, reflection of light, plane mirrors, spherical lenses, and colors. One of the most important senses that we human beings have is to see the world around us with our eyes. Light enables us to see. For thousands of years, people have been curious about lights, its properties, and its behaviors. The earliest experiments on light involved the study of light using mirrors and lenses. Let us study the pictures carefully as given below and try to answer the questions that follow. In picture 1, Aman is hiding behind a door. And he is trying to look around the open door with the help of a bent, hollow tube. Do you think he will be successful? Of course, he will not be successful because light travels in straight lines. So the light coming in straight lines cannot pass through the bent tube and reach his eyes. In figure 2, where do you think the colors of the city are coming from? Is the city itself colored? You must know, the white light is made up of 7 different colors, and the city has concentric pits, very, very small holes, which is equal to the wavelength of these different lights. So the lights coming out of the city plate is like a mirror reflecting and diffracting. It appears to be 7 different colors of the vision. In figure 3, Nancy is trying to get the sunlight passing through the window to fall on a wall by the side of the window. What do you think she is using to do this? She is actually using a mirror to reflect the sunlight into the room and fall on the wall. In figure 4, why do the images in the mirrors in amusement parks appear distorted? The mirror surfaces of these amusement parks are not plain mirrors but have curvatures. That means they are made in such a way that the images are in a funny way distorted. The study of light and its properties is both exciting and rewarding. So in this chapter we'll be learning about how light propagates or travels and how it behaves when it is reflected by mirrors and when it passes through lenses or through prisms. What is rectilinear propagation of light? As I told you earlier, light travels in straight lines in a uniform transparent medium or in vacuum. This straight line mode of propagation of light is called rectilinear propagation of light. Let us understand this with the following experiment. Activity: with the aim to verify the light travels in straight lines, you need a material like flexible rubber or a plastic tube or a straw about 10 to 12 inches long and a candle. Now, method would be to hold the tube absolutely straight and point one end of the tube at the source of the light and watch from the other. We'll be able to see the light or the candle flame. But in the case when we bend the tube and try to watch through the other end of the tube, this light source, we will not be able to see it because the bent tube does not allow the straight line traveling of the light reach our eyes. So the observation is giving to the conclusion that indicates the light travels in straight lines. Rectilinear propagation of light explains a lot of phenomena associated with light. One such phenomena is the formation of shadows. When you shine a torch in a dark room, you can see a beam of light. If you place a pencil in front of the lit candle, a shadow of the pencil can be seen on the wall. The shadow is formed when the pencil blocks the light traveling in straight lines from the source of the light on the opposite side of the wall. This is because of the rectilinear propagation of light, as you can see in figure 15.1. There are many instances in our daily lives when we come across rectilinear propagation of light. Can you see your friend if he is hiding behind a chair? Perhaps not, because the light traveling from your friend to you in straight lines and is blocked by the chair. However, if the light would have bent, then it would have gone past the chair and you would have been able to see your friend. Reflection of light. You can see an object when light falls on it. When light falls on a surface, it bounces off the surface, which is called reflection. Reflecting surfaces. All types of surfaces reflect light. That is why we can see them. When light from the sun or any other source falls on any object, we are able to see the object because the light reflected by the object reaches our eyes. While talking of reflection, we refer to a smooth surface as a regular surface and a rough and a wavy surface as an irregular surface. A regular surface reflects a parallel beam of light incident upon it in only one direction. Reflection by a regular surface is referred to as a regular reflection, as in figure 15.2a. A rough surface reflects a parallel beam of light incident upon it in all directions. The small bumps and irregularities on a rough surface cause each of the light rays to reflect in different directions. This kind of reflection is called irregular or diffuse reflection, as in 15.2b. Plane mirrors. Can you think of a plane reflecting surface? The mirror on the dressing table is a good example of a plane reflecting surface. Any smooth polished surface that can reflect the rays of light and form a clear image is called a mirror. Highly polished metal surfaces like stainless steel plates or the reflection in still water can act like a mirror. If you look at yourself closely in the mirror, what do you observe about your image? Is it bigger or smaller than you? Place the palm of your hand on the flat surface of the mirror and study its reflected image. Is the image bigger, smaller, or of the same size? It is of the same size, isn't it? Now move your hand slowly away from the mirror and observe the size of the image all the time. You'll find that the size of the image neither increases nor decreases in size, as in figure 15.4. However, as you move your hand away from the mirror, the image also moves away. The image is at the same distance behind the mirror as the object. Here, your hand is the object in front of the mirror. Lift your right hand, the image of the mirror appears to lift its left hand. This is called lateral inversion. Now stand in front of the mirror and see if you can touch your image formed in the mirror. You cannot, because the image seems to be behind the mirror. Such an image is called a virtual image. A virtual image cannot be formed on a screen. Do you notice anything else about your image? Is the image upside down as compared to you? It is not. Such an image is called upright image. Thus, a reflecting surface produces an image of a certain properties. These are called image characteristics. Let us summarize the image characteristics of a plane mirror, which are as follows, which you have to learn by heart. A plane mirror produces an upright virtual image. The image is of the same size as of the object. The distance of the image formed from the mirror equals the distance of the object in front of the mirror. The image in a plane mirror is laterally inverted and upright. Let's do an activity to study the reflection by a plane mirror, where the materials required would be a plane mirror, a sheet of paper and a pencil. We have to stand in front of the mirror, look at the image in the mirror and fill up the following observation table. Serial 1, question 1, is the image upright or inverted? Answer will be upright. Number 2, can you touch your image? Answer is no. Number 3, is the image real or virtual? Answer is virtual. Number 4, is the size of the image bigger or smaller than you, the object? It is same size as the object. Number 5, do your left and right side seem to be reversed in the image? Yes, it does. Number 1, when you move closer to the mirror, what happens to your image? The image becomes bigger and it moves forward. Number 2, what happens to your image when you move far away from the mirror? The image seems to be smaller and also move away from the mirror. And let us conclusion. From the above activity, we can see that a plane mirror forms a virtual upright image, which is same size as the object. The distance of the image formed behind the mirror is equal to the distance of the object in front of the mirror. These are called image characteristics of an image formed by a plane mirror. And let us finally do the let's remember part of page 230. Part A, fill in the blanks with the correct words. Number 1, A, dash, surface, smooth surface, reflects a parallel beam of light in only one direction. 2, irregular reflection is also called dash, diffuse reflection. 3, a mirror is a dash, surface, regular surface. Number 4, The image formed by plane mirror is dash virtual. B. Answer the following questions orally. Number 1. Why can't we see a source of light through a hollow bent tube? Light travels only in straight line, so it cannot pass through hollow bent tube. Number 2. Which expression is used to convey light travels in straight lines? Rectilinear propagation of light. Number 3. How are we able to see things around us? When light falls upon certain objects, it reflects off the light and we are able to see them. Number 4. Why can't we see our image in some surfaces and not in other surfaces? Because there are plane surfaces which produces regular reflections and we can see them. In cases there are rough surfaces, there are diffuse reflection, we cannot see them. Number 5. What property is common between the images of the following letters O, I, M and K? The lateral inversion is identical to the original alphabet. Write down another letter and a digit which will follow the same property as found in the letters given above. The question is, answer is W and the number is 8. That's all for today. Thank you very much. Bye.